I'd like to introduce you to lightning claw here at the Natural History Museum at UNE.
Best discoveries in the world are made in museum basements. Things that have been collected decades earlier and no one's looked at them in any detail, and someone comes along and opens up a drawer that hasn't been opened for 20 odd years and says, hang on, there's something interesting about those bones.
Lightning claw was actually discovered by a couple of opal miners in Lightning Ridge, Rob and Debbie Brogan, who donated it to the Australian Opal Centre. This was incredibly fortuitous, as it's the only place in the world dedicated to preserving these opalised fossils. Jenny Bramall and Elizabeth Smith, the two palaeontologists at the Australian Opal Centre, ushered me into their showroom to show me this prized display piece, which had sat on display and unstudied ever since. And when I picked up the claw of this animal, I knew we were looking at something very special.
We were able to take medical CAT scans of original bones and make three-dimensional digital models of them. So they could be manipulated and changed to match with the skeleton that we wanted to build. So each individual bone would have been changed in some way, especially on the length of the tail, where the bones gradually get longer and shallower. We're standing here with the skeleton of lightning claw, which is only based on a handful of bones that we actually found. And I'll show you those bones now. We start here with this foot bone called a metatarsal. We have part of the fibula or shin bone, a number of ribs, the ulna or one of the forearm bones, and then finally the giant killing claw on the hand. The skull, on the other hand, is quite delicately built. It has these thin, narrow jaws with only small teeth. So the skull overall was probably better suited to taking bites out of its prey rather than killing.